People have different interests, and vehicles is one of them. Collecting model buses and trains is a hobby for many across the world.
Now, this report is about the Batticaloa Model Railway System, which was constructed at a substantial cost and which we came by chance. And this is the report on the Batticaloa Model Railway System.
People have a lot of hobbies. They have a life, they love to do a lot of things. This is a different story, a different hobby. Let's have a look.
Darshan's train craze started at an early age when there was no internet or computers, even though many said that his addiction to trains will fade away. It didn't.
So, Mr. Darshan, I believe this is very interesting. So, tell me about this whole thing, the Batticaloa Model Railway.
Okay, Batticaloa Model Railway is my hobby, and I have been doing this in this room for more than around 4 years now. So this room was purposely built for the model railway because I had one at home and then that was taken down, and so now I'm having it in here. So this is quite a large layout. It has around 200 meters of track in two levels. This is one of the largest model railways in Sri Lanka. And so this is actually 1:76 or 1:87 scale. And they're called HO or WO scale. And this is actually, this layout is fully automated, and it's run by, it is called the DCC system, and it's run by the iTrain software. So it's fully automated. It will can run automatically on its own.
So people have dreams. People want to create a lot of new things in this world. So what made you create this Batticaloa Model Railway?
Because it was a childhood hobby, and before I left England, I had a look, and then I was really, interested in doing it because, it had the technology, it had the, artistic side of it. But I personally didn't actually believe that it will be this big and this, good looking and beautiful as well. So when I started getting involved with the hobby, I actually found a lot of things that I didn't know that I could do. So that is what one thing that was surprising for me. But for this, when you put your mind into it, you look at YouTube and all these things, you experiment, and you get so involved and you want to get everything perfectly done. It's a wonderful hobby, and there are so many elements to it. It's like running a real train. Railway, you have to keep the tracks clean, and you have to service the locomotives, you have to do the painting, everything is very, very interesting, and you don't get bored, because you can do electronics, and if you are bored with it, then you can just stop and do some painting, because far as the model railway is concerned, it never ends. You keep on adding, so it is known as the world's best hobby.
Where's best of you? Okay, yes. How many trains do we have here?
I have around 20 trains now.
20 yeah. trains, so yeah. How long will it take to, create everything? I mean, it's a pretty big area, it's yeah. not just one railway track, so yeah. How long will it take?
This layout in here, it took me around 4 years.
So Mr. Darshan, I believe you have created your hobby as one of the best things in this world, right? We have created a model railway, so there will be a lot of people, a lot of young kids who will be watching this, who will be having a lot of dreams, a lot of aspirations. So what is your message to all of them? Because you created your hobby into something very, very big. So what is your message that you can do?
My message is, I think it's when you are doing a hobby, you put your mind to it, and your soul into it, and then you enjoy what you do. So I don't get stressed about this, I don't hurry things. So it's actually, when you have a hobby, it's relaxing. It's time consuming. You have to time it correctly, because you don't want to start a hobby when you're studying. When you're doing your A levels, you don't want to start a hobby. So So those things you have to be a bit careful. But when you have the time, then it's always good to, because there might be some, people might not like it. Your home people might not like it. But you know, there is always a good side to it, because if you do, your kids will do it. You know, they will ask questions. They will come and help. Yeah, and so you know, there are a lot of aspects to it. You know, it's not about you only spending time. It's always there is so many elements to it, and there are so many things can actually go right, and people can learn, and others can learn, and you know, and it keeps you occupied. You know,
this country needs people with a vision like Dev Darshan, people who don't give up on their goals easily. People who are not limited to the railway systems built by the British.
மனிதர்கள் பல்வேறு விடயங்களை நேசிக்கின்றனர். அதில் வாகனங்கள் மீதான பிரியமும் அடங்குகின்றது. நாங்கள் பஸ் பைத்தியம், ரயில் பைத்தியம் என கூறினாலும் இந்த விடயம் சர்வதேச பொழுதுபோக்காக அமைகின்றது. மட்டக்களப்பில் தற்செயலாக நம் கவனத்தை ஈர்த்த, மில்லியன் கணக்கான பணம் செலவழித்து உருவாக்கப்பட்ட மட்டக்களப்பு மாதிரி ரயில் நிலையத்தின் அமைப்பு பற்றிய கதையே இது.
வந்த பிறகு இப்படி ஒரு பொழுதுபோக்கு இருக்கா அப்படின்னு சொல்லி வியக்க வைத்த ஒரு பொழுதுபோக்க நான் கண்டம். இங்க இருக்கிறாரு தர்ஷன், எங்களுடைய நண்பர் தர்ஷன். இவருடைய பொழுதுபோக்கு வித்தியாசமாயிருக்கிறது. காலத்துக்கேற்ப தொழில்நுட்பத்தோடு கூடிய, நவீன தொழில்நுட்பத்தோடு கூடிய ஒரு பொழுதுபோக்கு அம்சமாக இது காணப்படுறது. பொழுது தெரியும், ட்ரெயின் ஸ்டேஷன் அல்லது ரயில்வே ட்ராக், அதாவது நம்ம வெளிநாட்டுகளுக்கு போயிட்டு அமெரிக்காவிலேயோ கனடாவிலேயோ பிரான்ஸ்லேயோ இந்த ரயில்வே ட்ராக்ஸ் அல்லது இந்த ட்ரெயின் போகிற மாதிரிகளை வந்து பார்க்க தேவையில்லை. நீங்கள் மட்டக்களப்புக்கு வந்தீங்கன்னு சொன்னால் அந்த அனுபவத்தை நீங்கள் தர்ஷன் பொழுதுபோக்கு அம்சத்தில் பார்க்கலாம்.
தேவ தர்ஷனுக்கு ரயில் மீதான ஆர்வம் சிறுபராயத்திலிருந்தே உருவானதொன்று. இணையத்திடம் கணினி இல்லாத காலத்தில் உருவான இந்த ஆர்வம் பின்னர் ஒரு காலகட்டத்திலும் கைவிட்டுவிட முடியாத அளவுக்கு சென்றது.
சின்னன்லேயே நான் ஒரு 9-10 வயதுக்கு என்கிட்ட ஒரு ட்ரெயின் ஒன்று எனக்கு எங்கள் அங்கிள் வந்து ப்ரெசென்ட் பண்ணவர் சவுதியிலேருந்து. அப்போ நானும் என் கசினும் சேர்ந்து அதை போட்டு முதலே சின்னன்லேயே விளையாடுறாங்க. இப்போ முதல் இப்படியெல்லாம் இன்டர்நெட்லாம் வேண்டி விளையாண்டபடியே நாங்கள் அந்த கேட்லாக் ஒன்று இருக்கோம். அந்த கேட்லாக்கில் பார்த்து தான் எப்படிலாம் இருக்கிறாப்பான்னு சொல்லி இங்கிலாண்டில் இருக்கிற படங்கள் எல்லாம் போட்டிருப்பாங்க. சரியான வடிவாயெல்லாம் இருக்குது, நான் பார்த்துட்டு நல்லா இருக்கு செய்கிறேன்னா அப்போ அந்த நேரத்தில் செய்கிறதுக்குரிய வாய்ப்புகள் ஒன்றும் இருக்கல்ல.
சில காலம் வெளிநாட்டில் இருந்த தேவ் தர்ஷன் தனது பொழுதுபோக்கில் புது புது அம்சங்களை உள்ளடக்கிக் கொண்டிருந்தார். பல வருடங்கள் கழித்து இலங்கை திரும்பிய அவர் தற்போது ஒரு தொழிலதிபர். எவ்வாறாயினும் தேவ் தர்ஷன் ரயில்களை மறக்காமல் ஒரு அறையில் ரயில்வே மாதிரி கட்டமைப்பை உருவாக்கினார். இந்த கட்டமைப்பு முழுவதும் தன்னிச்சையாக இயங்கும். மின்சார ஒளி சமிக்ஞை சுரங்கப்பாதை ரயில் திசை திருப்பல் அமைப்பு குறித்த அறை முழுவதும் அமைக்கப்பட்டுள்ளது.
ஸ்கேலை பற்றி சொல்லி சொன்னால் இது வந்து உண்மையான ட்ரெயினோட 1:76 ஸ்கேல். இது 00 ஸ்கேல்னு சொல்லுவாங்க, HO ஸ்கேல்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. இது DCC என்று சொல்கிற சிஸ்டம். இது வந்து இந்த லேஅவுட் வந்து ஃபுல்லாக கம்ப்யூட்டரைஸ் பண்ணியிருக்குது, ஃபுல்லாக ஆட்டோமேட்டட். சும்மா விட்டோம்னா தண்ட வாட்டிலே எல்லாம் ஓடும். நம்ம வேணும் வேண்டாம் மேனுவலாக ஓடலாம், செமி மேனுவலாக ஓடலாம், நம்மளோட இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட்டுக்கு பொறுத்து. இப்போ நான் உங்களுக்கு பாக்கலையை காட்ட வரைக்கும் நான் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கில் போட்டுட்டு நான் பார்த்துட்டு இருந்துட்டு ஆக்களை கூட வந்துட்டு இருப்பேன். இப்போ நான் தனியாக வந்து செய்யக்க நான் செமி ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கில் ஓடுவேன், அப்படியே மேனுவலாகவும் ஓடுவேன். நான்
தேவ் தர்ஷன் போன்ற தூர நோக்கு கொண்டவர்கள் நாட்டுக்கு தேவை. லட்சியத்தை எளிதில் விட்டுவிடாதவர்கள். வெள்ளைக்காரர்கள் உருவாக்கிய தண்டவாளத்துக்கு மட்டுப்படுத்தப்படாத மக்களே நாட்டுக்கும் தேவைப்படுகின்றனர்.
මිනිසු එක එක දේවල් වලට ආදරය කරනවා.
යාන වාහන කියන්නේ ඒ අතරින් එකක්.
අපි බස් පිස්සුව කෝච්චි පිස්සුව කියලා කිව්වට මේක දැන් ජාත්‍යන්තර විනෝදාංශයක් බවට පත් වෙලා.
මඩකලපුවේදී අහන්පින් හම්බ වුණු මිලියන ගණනක් වියදම් කරලා ගොඩ නගපු මඩකලපුව ආපෘති දුම්රිය පද්ධතිය ගැනයි මේ කතාව.
ට්‍රන්ස්පෝර්ටේෂන් ගැන තියෙන්නේ වෙනම අදහසක්. එක්ක අපිට තියෙන බස්, එක්ක අපිට තියෙන ට්‍රේන්. දාඩිය පෙරාගෙන එළිලා මේ දෙකෙන් යන්න ඕන. බොහොම විනසකාරී ගමන් දෙකක්. ඒ වගේ විරාමක විතනාද විනෝදාංශයක් විදිහට හවදාම ට්‍රේන් ස්ටේෂන් එකක් දාගන්න. එහෙම ට්‍රේන් ස්ටේෂන් එකක් දාගත්ත යාළුවෙක් අපුරු නම් වුණා මඩ කලපුවේ. ඒ දර්ශන.
දේව දර්ශන්ගේ කෝච්චි පිස්සුව පටන් ගන්නේ පුංචි කාලෙමයි. ඉන්ටර්නෙට් තියා කම්පියුටරයක්වත් නැති කාලෙක ඔළුවට ගහපු කෝච්චි පිස්සුව පස්සේ කාලෙක මග හැරිලා යයි කියලා කිව්වට එහෙම වෙලා නැහැ.
මේක මගේ හොබි වගේ තමයි මම හදන්නේ. දැන් මේක මට පුංචි කාලෙන් මට පොඩි එකක් පොඩි ලේඅවුට් එකක් අපිට මගේ අංකල් එක දුන්නා මට ප්‍රසන්ට් වගේ එකක් දාලා මගේ අයියත් එක්ක දාලා අපි ඉස්සෙල්ල ගන්නවා එක. මේක අර ඉන්ටර්නෙට් මුකුත් තිබ්බ නැහැ ඒ කාලේ. නිකන් කැටලොග් එකක් තිබ්බා. එකකින් බලලා කොහමද තියෙන්නේ කියලා මේ ඉංග්ලන්ඩ් එකේ තියෙන ලේඅවුට් ස්කේප් පින්තූර තමයි බලන්න තිබ්බේ ඒ කාලේ.
කාලයක් විදේශ ගත වෙලා හිටපු දේව් දර්ශන් දෙකින් දිගටම තම විනෝදාංශයේ නව ප්‍රවණතා ගැන අවධානයෙන් පසු වුණා. වසර ගණනාවකට පස්සේ ආපහු ලංකාවට ආපු ඔහු අද විශාල ව්‍යාපාරිකයෙක්. ඒ මොනවත් තිබුණත් දේව් දර්ශන් කෝච්චිය අමතක කළේ නැහැ. ඔහු කාමරයක දුම්රිය ගමන් පද්ධතියක් ගොඩනගලා මේක සම්පූර්ණයෙන් ස්වයංක්‍රීයවත් ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන්න පුළුවන්. විදුලි ආලෝක සංඥා උමං මාර්ග දුම්රිය හැරවුම් පද්ධතියක්ද මේ කාමරය පුරා විහිද පවතිනවා.
දැන් මේක i train කියලා එකක් තමයි මේක control කරන්නේ. මේක දැන් DCC digital command center කියලා system එකෙන් fully automated layout එක. මේ layout එකෙන් 200 meters track තියෙනවා මේක. ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ තියෙන වැඩිපුර track තියෙන layout එකක්. fully automated ඉඳලා මේක මම නිකන් automatic දැම්මා නම් train collide කරන්න නැතුව නිකන් එක යනවා. කවුරුරි කට්ටිය එන බලන්න එනකොට මම normally automatic fully automatic mode එකකින් තමයි දුවන්නේ. ඒක දැන් මේක තියෙන එක 2 layers එකකින් තියෙන්නේ. පල්ලිය තියෙන එක fiddle yard කියන්නේ එකෙන් trains ඔක්කොම park කරලා තියන්නේ. උඩ තමයි scenery running ඔක්කොම උඩ තමයි කරන්නේ මේක. අඩි 40 feet track තියෙනවා. මොනවාද මේ ඉඳලා මේක 18 inches මේ gap එක. මේ 18 inch gap එකට train එක උඩට එන්නට 45 feet track ඕනේ. ඒක අර helix එකෙන් gradually එක climb වෙලා උඩ තට්ටුවට ආවිලා ඊට පස්සේ ඒක උඩ run වෙනවා.
රටට අවශ්‍ය දේව් දර්ශන් වගේ දර්ශනයක් තියෙන මිනිස්සු තමන්ගේ අරමුණ ලේසියෙන් අත් නොහරින මිනිස්සු සුද්ද හදපු රේල් පීලට විතරක් සීමා නොවුණු මිනිස්සු.